speaker, at the outset, on behalf of my party and myself, I would like to congratulate the Honorable Chief Minister Saab and his party on the victories of TRS in civic polls in Greater Hyderabad, Municipal Corporation, Warangal, Khammam, Municipal Corporations. The people have reposed their confidence and trust in TRS government. These victories also signify the hope and expectation that the TRS government has raised among the people, particularly among the poorer section and lower middle class sections. The poor believe the government's promises that they would be given two-bedroom flats all across the state, particularly in twin cities of Hyderabad, Secunderabad, where the housing shortage is severe. The people also believe the government promised that it would provide water connection in every household. Under the mission Bhagiratha, the farmers have hoped that the mission Kakatiya would rejuvenate the irrigation tanks in villages and provide them the much needed water. The two-bedroom housing, as well as the waiver of water and power bill arrears, as also reduction in property tax bills of the poor section of the GHMC and other areas, have prompted the people in Hyderabad and other civic bodies to vote for the TRS in a big way. Madam, I would like to recall that my party, AIMM, had urged the Honorable Chief Minister in May 2014 itself, before the TRS government assumed office, and we had lended our support to the government also at that time. We had made this request to waive the water and power bill arrears as well as property tax due for the poor section in Hyderabad, for which we thank the Honorable Chief Minister Saab for agreeing and accepting the demand made by the MIM party. Since the formation of Telangana state and the advent of TRS government, the people have lots of aspirations, and the ruling party would do them justice and work their all-around welfare and overall development of the state. The government has already completed 21 months in office, and the Honorable Governor in his address to the state legislatures has recalled some of the events and policy initiated and launched during this period. As the Governor says, the budget is a roadmap to the future. We are told that the government has prepared the year's budget after detail and a very big exercise. Though the Honorable Governor spoke at length about agriculture and allied sector, however, he has been silent on the severe drought and the consequent drinking water shortage and the fodder scarcity across the state. Madam, I may recall that the Governor has submitted a memorandum to the central government on the drought of Telangana in November 2015. The state government had declared 231 out of 443 mandals in the state as drought affected and sought an immediate assistance of 1,000 crores of central government for taking up relief measures. While the mandals in Mahbubnagar, Medak and Nizamabad district were declared as drought hit, a large number of mandals in Rangarati, Karimnagar, Nalgunda and Varangar were also declared as drought affected. None of the mandals in Adilabad and Kamar district were affected by the drought as per the government assessment. I don't know how reliable is the system to determining the quantum of rainfall. I think the rain gauges in the mandals are not the real indicators of the rainfall, but more reliable data would be quantum of water reserves in tank and dams and the status of crop. The Telangana government has submitted a detailed memorandum on the drought situation to the government, central government. Central team visited the drought hit districts in December 2015. The crop loss due to drought conditions in Telangana has been estimated at rupees 3,000 crore by the central team that visited the state. However, the high-level committee chaired by the Union Home Minister Sri Rajnath Singh approved the assistance of rupees 791 crores from the National Disaster Relief for Telangana and other states. Like Maharashtra, were given assistance of thousands of crores, but our Telangana state has been given a raw deal in central government. I would like to know from Honorable Chief Minister Saab how much money has been released so far by the central government out of the assistance of rupees 791 crores announced on January 14 this year. Despite the severe drought situation that has impacted the revenue collection of the state, to some extent the Director of Economic and Statistics has sounded very optimistic The gross state domestic product as per advanced estimate is estimated to grow at 11.7% in 2015 and 16 as against the projected national growth of 8.6%. Telangana GSDP is estimated at rupees 5.83 crores with the growth in sector, secondary sector estimated at 8.3% and the service sector of 14.9%. The primary sector comprising agriculture allied activities is expected to register a meager growth of 0.8% due to the adverse seasonal condition in 2015 and 16. However, data from other sources show that the agriculture allied sector registered a negative growth of 1.9%, with agriculture alone accounting for minus growth of 18.2%. I would like to know the details of the likely fall in production of food grains, pulses, edible oil, horticulture and other crops in Kharif and Rabi season in current agricultural year. Farmer suicide are again being reported to the distress caused drought condition and harassment meted out by the money lenders, including the banks and money lenders. I am told that the state government itself has informed the Honorable High Court that 150 farmers had committed suicide in 2 months, that is December 2015 and January 2016. The government also informed the High Court that it has directed all the district collectors to ascertain the reasons for the same. I would like the Honorable Chief Minister Saab to brief us on the issue of farmer suicide. I may also recall that in September 2015, the government has enhanced the ex-gratia from 1.5 lakhs to 6 lakhs for families of farmers who committed suicide. I would like to know how many families of farmers, helpless farmers, have been provided with enhanced ex-gratia so far. Farmers' organizations allege that more than 1,500 farmer suicide have occurred in Telangana state in last 21 months. What is the official count by the Telangana government, even though the National Crime Records Bureau has quoted as much high figure of farmer suicide? Madam, the governor has pointed out that the per capita income, which is an important indicator of standard of living of the people, is likely to increase to rupees 1.43 lakhs from rupees 1.29 lakhs in 2014 and 15, as compared to the national per capita of rupees 93,231. I don't know how the Director of Economics and Statistics has given the advance estimate when the farmers, who constitute more than 2/3 of state population, are facing distress to some extent due to drought conditions. The governor has also recalled that the government created a record by coming up with a budget of rupees 1.15 lakh crore for 2015 and 16 with plan allocation of rupees 52,000 crore. This meant doubling the per capita plan allocation since 2013 and 14. I do not want to talk about the state finances, since the budget for the next financial year 2016 and 17 is being presented in legislature on Monday. So, however, I have repeatedly been saying in this house, the state of state finances is not up to the mark. For this reason, the state could not achieve the target, spending rupees 105 lakh in 2014 and 15, including the supplementary estimates in current year 2. I'm afraid the government may not be able to achieve the budgeted outlay of rupees 1,15,689 crores. One of the key reasons for the shortfall in the budgeted expenditure in the two financial years from 2014-15 and 15 and 16 is a steep fall in flow of funds from the central government. Telangana state gets much lower quantum of share of central taxes compared to residue state of AP. Telangana got a share of rupees 10,092 crores in central tax revenues as against 2014 and 15. Telangana got only 12,595 crores as against AP share of rupees 22,236 crore in 2015 and 16. In the next financial year 2016 and 17, Telangana is stated to get 13,955 crores as against AP share of 24,637 crores. So we need to make this point to the government of India and demand that a proper share is being given to the state of Telangana. Because unless and until we get a proper and a guaranteed help from the government of India, the Telangana state cannot go ahead and fulfill the promises made to the people of Telangana, sir. Honorable CPNS Saab had repeatedly urged the government to raise the borrowing limit of the state government under the Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act from 3% to 3.5% of the GSDP to raise funds for the flagship programs as Mission Kakatiya, Mission Bhagirathi, and irrigation project, as well as two-bedroom housing scheme. As I have pointed out in the last two budget sessions, the central government has substantially reduced its planned grant as well as the funds for central scheme to the states, thereby putting further strain on the state finances. The central government has closed down several central schemes and changed the pattern of funding for many other central schemes. The reduction in the flow of funds for these central schemes have severely affected the funding of various key programs. The state itself lacks adequate resources to tide over the reduction in central grant for central scheme. I would discuss this in greater detail during the discussion on budget, madam. I compliment the government for launching the several initiatives for the welfare of the poor section of SCSTs, BCs and minority economically backwardness section of people. Our party welcomed the Shadi Mubarak and the Kalyana Lakshmi scheme, which fulfill our long standing demand for providing higher quantum assistance for marriage of poor girls. But at the same time, I would like to come on record and say that many irregularities have been committed, and I demand that the government have an inquiry done and find out the reasons. The real needy and the poor has not been provided with assistance in this Shadi Mubarak and the other schemes, madam. Our party has been appreciating and supporting the initiative taken by the TRS government for the minorities, including higher allocation for minorities welfare in the last 2 years. However, the government has released all the allocated amount to the minority welfare department during 2014 and 15, as well as the current year. Already on behalf of MIM, we have recently represented the Honorable Chief Minister Saab requesting to release all the allocated fund in current year. The fund has not yet been released. I want to make a request to the government to kindly release the allocated fund. I would once again request Honorable Chief Minister Saab to release the balance funds of Minorities Welfare Department before the financial year draws to a close. I request for disbursement of all post-matric scholarship and reimbursement of tuition fee arrears of all students for the financial and academic year 2013 and 14 and 14 and 15 before 31st of March. This is very important, madam, because the students are suffering. Moreover, I would urge the government to realize the subsidy for self-employment bankable scheme for minority sanction for the 2014 financial year before March 31. For the current financial year, the Minority Welfare Department has not released any amount towards scholarship and fees reimbursement. For minority students, similarly, the government opened online application for subsidy for bankable schemes only in February 2016. For current financial year, the date for filling the application has been extended to March 15 on the request of our party. Already 1.41 lakh applications have been received by Telangana State Minority Finance and Christian Finance Corporation so far. The subsidy amount required for these applications would be 2,500 crores. For this reason, our party has requested Honorable CM Saab to release 500 crores for the subsidy scheme of minorities, madam. For several years, the students as well as the subsidy beneficiaries have not been getting the benefits in the same financial year. The beneficiaries for 1 year are paid their money in next financial year. This backlog or carryover practice has become the rule with all the welfare department, SC, tribal, minority and BC welfare. I urge the government to ensure that all the students for the scholarship and fee reimbursement for academic year 2015 and 16 and all eligible beneficiaries under subsidy for bankable schemes who are applying now for 2015 and 16 financial year get their disbursement in the first quarter of the ensuing financial year during April and June 2016. Similarly, the students and loanees for ensuing 2016 and 17 should get the disbursement before and end the financial year. There shall be no backlog or carry forward scholarship and subsidized loan. Our party welcomes the Chief Minister Saab's decision to start 70 residential schools for minority throughout the state. This has been a long standing demand of MIM party to open residential school for the minorities in the mandals. Madam, at the same time, I would like to request the government to please not just open these residential schools. I request the facilities provided to the SC and ST hostel and residential schools, the same facility should be provided for the 70 minority residential schools also. Because if that has not been provided, then the success story will not be for the 70 residential schools. Like, I just want to give some few examples, like free lodging and boarding facilities are provided for these boarders. The diet charges are paid for SC students for 750 per month, boarders up to 7th class, and 850 for boarders from 8th to 10th class, like cosmetic charges, haircut charges, bedding material, 4 pair of dresses, special hostel study material is also given, books are being given free. So if such things are being done in these minority residential schools, then it will become a success story. Why I say this is that, madam, whether it is Gopal Singh Commission report or whether it is Sachar Committee or Ranganath Misra, all these reports has identified and has established that the minorities are weaker than SCs and STs in field of education and employment. We need to give special focus and attention for upliftment of the minorities. Our party welcomes the Chief Minister's decision to start 70 residential schools, and we are also thankful to KCR sir for considering our demands for minority. Responding to a plea, the TRS government has started overseas study scholarship scheme for minorities initiated, and also this direct loaning, we appreciate this, and quantum of subsidy for bank loans also. Enhance the income ceiling of rupees 1.5 lakhs to rural area and 2 lakhs in urban areas for availing benefits under various government schemes, and affected age relaxation for subsidy loans, and CM Saab has sanctioned assistance for construction of auditorium for Jamia Nizamia. All these works have been addressed by the government. We are very thankful to the government, and I may recall that the Telugu Desam TDP government in neighboring Andhra Pradesh had introduced a backward class sub plan for 2015 and 16 financial year. I urge the Honorable Chief Minister Saab to introduce the BC sub plan and minority sub plan in Telangana state. We have already requested the CM Saab to extend the benefits to Muslims on par with SCs and STs in state. KCR Saab has positively responded to our plea. We request the government to issue necessary orders in this regard, madam. SC and STs, already CM Saab humko vada kar rahe hain ki on par with SC and STs karenge. To main ye baat, ye mutalaba isliye kar raha hu, madam, aapke zariye hukumat se, ki agar SC aur STs ke barabar agar minorities aur musalman ko bhi agar marad diye jate hain, to musalmanon ke bahut se fayde honge. 12% जब आएगा, 4% रिजर्वेशन चल रहा है, चलेगा, लेकिन रिजर्वेशन के साथ साथ हमको यह देखना है कि बगैर रिजर्वेशन के किस तरीके से मुसलमान की मदद की जा सकती है. When all the reports say that के Muslims are backward than SCs and STs, so all the benefits that have been provided to SCs and STs, like the attempts for the government jobs, should be on same for Muslim minority students as it is for SCs and STs. The passing marks should also be made same. All the benefits should be provided to minority students also. Madam, I would like to point out the case relating to 4% reservation for socially and educationally backward class of Muslim state has come up before the bench of the Supreme Court, though the governor has not mentioned about the TRS government commitment to raise the quantum of reservation for backward Muslim at 12%. We know that the Sudhir Commission of Inquiry constituted by the government is on the job of making full proof case for 12% quota for backward Muslims. Right from the beginning, we have been cautioning the government against any hasty move to enhance the quota to 12% for backward Muslims without proper homework, as this may affect the existing 4% reservation for backward Muslims being implemented as per the Supreme Court. We would like to request Honorable CM Saab to direct the Advocate General and Law Department to constitute a team of legal luminaries and effectively argue the state case in favor of 4% reservation of backward Muslims. The Telangana government may also coordinate with Andhra Pradesh government to defend the 4% quota in the Supreme Court, because any adverse verdict in this case may have its impact of the proposed enhancement of reservation to the 12% also, madam. The governor's address makes no mention of the recruitment in state services promised by the TRS government There are thousands of vacant posts which needs to be filled up on a priority basis. And also, madam, about the work properties, I would like to request the honorable, when I talk about the work properties, I would like to first thank the honorable Chief Minister Sahab and the TRS government for allotting 4,000 change square yards of land of PWD department for a construction of an orphanage of by the name Anisil Gurba, madam. That property is worth more than 25 to 30 crores, which has been handed over to the orphanage for the poor Muslims to be constructed. I thank the government. At the same time, मैं ये भी जरूर कहना चाहूंगा वर्क प्रॉपर्टीज के बारे में चीफ मिनिस्टर साहब से हम बार बार मुतालबा करते आए हैं और 10 बरस से मुसलसिल मजलिस इत्तेहाद अल मुस्लिमीन और मैं आंध्र प्रदेश असेंबली में भी और आज तेलंगाना असेंबली में भी लड़ते आए हैं कि औकाफी जायदादों का तहफ्फुज़ होना चाहिए. मणिकोंडा जागीर हजरत हुसैन शाह वली रहमतुल्लाह अलैह की दरगाह की आराजी जो जहां पर अलॉट की गई थी मल्टीनेशनल कंपनीज को, विप्रो को, माइक्रोसॉफ्ट को, ईमार को, 1600 एकर्स अनअलॉटेड लैंड, अनयूज लैंड इज 700 एकर्स. मैं हुकूमत से दरखास्त करूंगा कि एक पब्लिक रिप्रेजेंटेटिव एमएलए या एमएलसी की एक हाउस कमेटी बनाइए और उस हाउस कमेटी को अहकाम दीजिए कि 10 दिन या 15 दिन में एक रिपोर्ट स्टडी कर दे ताकि जो भी जमीन जो अलॉट नहीं हुई है, वेकेंट है, दैट लैंड कुड बी हैंडेड ओवर टू वर्क बोर्ड. ऑलमोस्ट 600 to 700 एकर्स इज अनअलॉटेड मैडम. एंड आई वुड लाइक टू कम ऑन रिकॉर्ड एंड से दैट अगर वर्क प्रॉपर्टीज को सही तरीके से इस्तेमाल किया जाएगा मुसलमानों के वेलफेयर प्रोग्राम्स के लिए, एजुकेशनल अपलिफ्टमेंट के लिए, स्किल डेवलपमेंट के लिए, तो मैं समझता हूं कि स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से कोई मदद की जरूरत नहीं है. वक्फ बोर्ड खुद मुसलमान बच्चों के जिंदगियों में एक नई इनकलाबी तब्दीली ला सकता है हमारे आबा अजदाद ने जो वक्फ किया है उस जमीन का सही इस्तेमाल करते हुए. तो मैं चीफ मिनिस्टर साहब से दोबारा मुतालबा करूंगा कि औकाफी या हुसैन शाह रहमतुल्लाह अलैह की दरगाह की जमीन की आराजी के लिए कमेटी तश्कील दें और खुली आराजी को वापस दें. एंड मैडम ऑल्सो इवन एज अ प्राइवेट अबाउट गोइंग टू स्कूल एजुकेशन मैडम, even as the private schools all over the state are exploiting the helpless parents and by increasing the fees and collecting the donations, and I am told that out of 25,266 government schools, the government is closing down 7,458 schools in ground that have only 30 students. A joint action committee of तो मैडम आई एम सरप्राइज दैट विद बाई क्लोजिंग 7,458 स्कूल्स वे विल दी स्टूडेंट्स बी अकोमोडेटेड वे विल द स्टूडेंट्स गो एंड एट द सेम टाइम व्हेन वी सी दैट द प्राइवेट स्कूल्स आर कलेक्टिंग ह्यूज फीस मैडम इन तमिलनाडु देर इज अ लेजिस्लेशन मैडम वेयर द प्राइवेट स्कूल्स कैन नॉट कलेक्ट एनी फीस एज दे वॉन्ट. आई रिक्वेस्ट द गवर्नमेंट टू प्लीज कॉन्स्टिट्यूट a committee to look into that and also see that the private schools which are collecting fees ranging from tens of thousands for a few lakhs per student per annum have raised the fees and donations. So in case there is one joint action committee also which has demanded that there shall be no fee hike for the next academic year in 2016-17 in all private school. They have also sought enactment of new law to give statutory status for autonomous fee regulation on the lines of such law in other states such as Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra and Delhi. Moreover, the JSE has demanded bringing the schools under preview of existing admission and fee regulation committee set up for the colleges. I request the Honorable CM Saab to consider these guidelines, demand of parents of students studying in the private schools. At the same time, Madam Deputy Speaker, through you I would like to request the government to please give some incentives to those schools who are providing free education to the poorest of poor people. A new regulation has been brought in force where they are demanding that all teachers should be BEd. Like I want to give an example of schools which I run, where 10,000 children are being provided free education, free books, free dress. In these schools, I just get some 10th pass or 12th pass girls and I teach them and I train them to teach the students. And with which we are providing employment to those girls. Now regulation has come up and says that कि ऑल टीचर्स शुड बी बीएड. इफ दिस रेगुलेशन इज इन फोर्स देन मेनी स्कूल्स विल सफर. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट द गवर्नमेंट टू काइंडली लुक इनटू दिस. बिफोर आई गो इनटू अदर इश्यूज आई वुड लाइक टू हाईलाइट द कंसर्न्स ऑफ कॉमन मैन. देयर इज अ टॉक दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज प्रिपेयरिंग टू बर्डन द पीपल विद द स्पेट ऑफ हाइक इन टैक्सेस एंड अदर लीवीज. द ग्रेटर हैदराबाद म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफिसर्स हैव ऑलरेडी हिंटेड दैट द प्रॉपर्टी टैक्स रिविजन इज लॉन्ग ओवरड्यू एंड GHMCV would take up exercise to hike the property tax for the residential and commercial properties. The two DISCOMs, Telangana State Southern Power Distribution Company, Northern Power Distribution Company, have already filed their annual revenue receipt document to Telangana State Electricity Regulatory Commission seeking a 9% hike in power tariff for residential, commercial and industrial consumers to get additional revenue of rupees 2,000 crores. The Telangana State Road Transport Corporation losses are mounting despite the GHMC contribution. The funds offsetting its losses on RTC city bus operation, the TSRTC is also seeking hike in bus fares. The Hyderabad Metropolitan Water Supply Sewerage Board has also approached the government with proposal for hike in water tariff for domestic, commercial, industrial consumers. The proposed hike in power tariff rates, water rates, bus fares and property taxes would place an unbearable burden on thousands of crores of rupees on the common man. When they respond and reiterate the trust and confidence TRS government recent Lok Sabha assembly by-election and the civic election, GHMC, Warangal and Common Corporation, the people least expected that they would burden with such taxes and tariff hike so soon after the election. I request the government to seek other options for raising finances instead of increasing the power tariff, property tax and water rates and the bus tariff, madam. After formation of Telangana, government has taken several initiatives to help the poor. The pension of widows and other 35 lakh people, persons are getting the pension, but I'm sure lakhs of people are still awaiting. And I would like to also come on record and say that in Hyderabad city, I don't know about the other district, in Hyderabad city from last 2 months, the pensions have not reached to the pensioners. Kindly release those pensions. It is going to be a third month, my madam. After the intensive household survey, the government has revamped the pension scheme distribution. And also, madam, an important point, I would like to know from the Honorable Chief Minister Saab whether the principle of reservation of SC, ST, BCs would be followed in regularization of contract employees. Regularization of contract employees, madam. If not, this would be a big infringement of the statutory reservation and mark for SC, STs and BCs in the state. We are not against. Let me come on record and say that we are not against the regularization of the contract employees. But at the same time, not just SC, STs and BCs, what is needed to be seen is that the people who would be regularized are locals or non-locals also. Without doing this exercise, regularization of this contract employees should not happen. This is a very important issue, madam. Some measures have also been taken for toning up the healthcare sector. Government-run hospital, teaching hospital, area hospital, primary health center. My party welcomed the proposal of the government to start 4 new super speciality hospitals in different locations in Hyderabad to cater to the needs of growing population in the state capital. However, I would like to recall the budgetary allocation for centering all existing government hospitals, including Usmania, Gandhi and other super speciality hospitals in state budget 2014-15, period 16, have not been released so far. When we talk about the hospital, madam, I would request Honorable Chief Minister Saab to please tell Honorable Deputy Chief Minister and the Health Minister to make a visit of Charminar Unani Hospital, madam. That is the only Unani hospital where the medium of education is in Urdu. Many posts are lying vacant, teaching faculty is less, and because of that, the Unani medicine is suffering, and such a beautiful heritage structure is not been getting maintained. We need to protect that education, Unani medicine. And also, madam, under Mission Bhagirath, the government has promised to provide tapped water connection to every household in the state. Moreover, the government has contemplated construction of 2 major reservoirs in north and south of Hyderabad to augment water supply GHMC adjoining areas under Mission Kakatiya. All water bodies in the state are being rejuvenated in phased manner. Our party hope that these schemes would successfully implemented and government will be able to raise the required fund for the construction. At the same time, I request the government to please call for a meeting and have a summer contingency plan for the water scarcity which is there prevailing in Hyderabad and Secunderabad city, and all the unserved areas should be provided water with water tankers. And additional water tankers are needed, and lot of places we are having pollution. People are facing a very big problem right now. I would say the challenge for the residents of Hyderabad and Secunderabad, it is water and supply of water, madam. I hope that the government would allocate some special funds to tackle this summer and see that the water scarcity is been tackled, madam. And again, and also request that some few new borewells should be given after checking, because the groundwater table has gone very low. So the bore should not go waste. We need to see this also, madam. At the same time, madam, our party welcomed the recent agreement signed with Maharashtra for the resolving the interstate issue of sharing of Godavari waters and for construction of 5 new barrages in 2 states. The government has proposed 2 new irrigation projects besides redesigning and re-engineering of other irrigation projects under implementation, including Pranayita Chivalla project. The lift irrigation project state requires 8,000. Madam, the lift irrigation in the state require 8,500 megawatts of power to lift the water from the rivers. I would like to know from the Honorable Chief Minister Saab to enlighten us on this aspect also. Okay, where are we going to get 8,500 megawatts of power and how? The state has drawn up an ambitious plan to supply uninterrupted power to the all consumers in the state during 2016-17 besides 9 hours power supply to agriculture sector. There is also plan underway to augment the power generating capacity in the state to 23,912 megawatts next 3 years at a massive outlay of 91,500 crores. Similar government has come up with a new industrial policy, investor-friendly initiative, TSI pass. The state has accorded clearance to 100 units, including those belonging to reputed corporate groups. I would like the CMSR to give details of this major units in the state implementation of these new industrial projects. We are told that 3 aerospace park, pharma city, national investment and manufacturing zone and textile parks have been planned at different locations in the state. Some global IT companies have decided to set up large development centers in Hyderabad. I would like to know the details of T-Hub and also being set up as the largest start-up incubator in the country. I would also like to know the details of 40,000 engineering students who have been provided with the skill training in Telangana Academy of Skill and Knowledge, madam. The government has launched an ambitious scheme to provide double bedroom houses for poor instead of single room tenant. About 60,000 houses were sanctioned in 10 districts. At the same time, madam, I would like to remind to the government is that the most important is that more than 5 years back, the then Congress government has collected 5,000, 10,000, 15,000 rupees also from the poor people, saying that they will be provided with housing. That money is still lying with the government and they have not been provided with the houses. So kindly, and I would also like to know, the state government has said that there has been lot of misappropriation in the implementation of housing by the then Congress government. An inquiry was supposed to be ordered. What is the outcome of that inquiry needs to be known to this house also, madam. Madam, at the same time, the demand for the houses is very much. I don't know how the government is going to make availability of the land in Hyderabad city, because that is a very big problem, madam. But I wish my best wishes and my prayers are there with the government, and I hope and pray that this promise of 2-bedroom becomes a reality, because poor people have lot of hope on this government and this scheme, madam. The government has already ambitious plan to provide 4-lane connectivity to all district headquarters of the state capital, 2-lane road to all mandal headquarters of district headquarters with road length of 15,000 kilometers and 358 new bridges. The governor has not spelt out where the funds will come for this ambitious project. I would like the government to please tell me where is the funds going to come, madam. Our party has been demanding for CCTV cameras all over the Hyderabad for effective crime control driven cities. We welcome the government's decision to install 1 lakh CCTV cameras in Hyderabad and to set up world-class police command control center with the latest technology. The Hyderabad Cyber Police need to focus on better traffic management and GHMC area to check rising number of accidents and death in the city, madam. At the same time, before concluding, madam, main aapke zariye hukumat se ye kehna chahta hu ki purane sheher ki tarakki ke liye Charminar pedestrianization project laya gaya tha, aur wo Charminar pedestrianization project aaj tak bhi takmeel nahi hua. Whole city mein road widenings ki zarurat hai, rozgar ko marbut karne ki zarurat hai. Aur main ye bhi kahunga ki purane sheher ko tarakki dene ki baatein ki gayi, lekin पुराने शहर को तरक्की नए शहर के बराबर नहीं दी गई. तो मैं उम्मीद करता हूं कि यह हुकूमत पुराने शहर को भी उसी तरीके से तरक्की देगी जिस तरीके से नए शहर को तरक्की दी गई. हम चाहते हैं कि जिस तरीके से आईटी का जो हब है हाईटेक सिटी में, एक छोटा सा ब्रांच ही सही पुराने शहर में या पुराने शहर के आगे भी उसका आगाज करें। और मैं ये भी आपसे कहूंगा मैडम कि वी हैव अ सेटविन, सेटविन जो बनाया गया था पुराने शहर के बेरोजगार लोगों को रोजगार देने के लिए, आज सेटविन में काम हो रहा है लेकिन कोई पूछने वाला नहीं है क्यों नहीं। मुझे याद है कि जब सबसे पहले कांग्रेस के दौरे हुकूमत में आंध्र प्रदेश में हरीश राव साहब उसके मिनिस्टर थे, सेटविन का मसला भी उनके मिनिस्ट्री में आता था, वो बेहतर जानते हैं। सेटविन को क्यों नहीं माइनॉरिटी वेलफेयर डिपार्टमेंट में मर्ज कर देते हैं? प्लीज मर्ज सेटविन विद माइनॉरिटी वेलफेयर डिपार्टमेंट सो दैट माइनॉरिटी वेलफेयर डिपार्टमेंट मेक्स बेस्ट यूज ऑफ द सेटविन एंड ट्रेन द मुस्लिम यूथ। एंड ऑल्सो न्यू सेंटर्स नीड टू बी फॉर्म्ड इन ओल्ड सिटी ऑफ नैक एंड फैशन डिजाइनिंग। निफ्ट के सेंटर्स के ब्रांचेस भी अगर ओल्ड सिटी में आएंगे तो कई लोगों को रोजगार मिलेगा। एंड इन कंक्लूजन आई वुड लाइक टू अशोर द गवर्नमेंट दैट वी वुड एक्सटेंड अवर फुल कोऑपरेशन इन इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द मेजर स्कीम्स प्रोग्राम्स एंड प्रोजेक्ट्स इन द स्टेट। आई एक्सटेंड माय सपोर्ट टू द मोस्ट ऑफ थैंक्स ऑन द गवर्नर एड्रेस एंड आई थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
एग्जांपल वी सेलिब्रेटेड वुमेन्स डे, द सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैड सेड अलाउड डांस बार्स इन मुंबई एंड द सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑल्सो सेड दैट पीपुल हु पैट्रोनाइज डांस बार्स देयर राइट टू प्राइवेसी विल बी प्रोटेक्टेड। इट इज अमेजिंग, people who patronize dance bars, their privacy is protected, but what about this, what about the Indians, what about people who are outside?